Okay, so hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. This is the first class of Islamia. Okay, and I hope you are all fine. Okay, at the end of the session, I'm going to take your attendance, but right now, let's start with the lecture. Okay, first of all, you all must have your worksheet pack, right? How many of you have your worksheet pack?
I have.
Okay, very good. And those who don't have their worksheet pack, kindly go to your school and get your worksheet back from there. Okay, as we are going to start with our worksheets and you are going to left behind. Okay, so let's start with our worksheet number one, that is the important status of a teacher. Okay, all the topics that we are going to study now are the topics that were left behind in the summer term. Okay, we are going to start with this worksheet. Okay, everyone take out this page and we are going to I'm going to tell you the important status of a teacher. What does the important status of a teacher mean? Okay, it means that how important the teachers are. A status is basically how top of something or someone is. Okay, so basically kya hai ki teachers kitni zyada important hoti hain aur unka jo hai wo status Islam mein kya. Okay, we are going to read it in Islamic way. Okay, and or automatically in the next way as well. Okay, now I'm going to give you a little summary of overall comprehension and then I'll ask you if there are any problems. Okay, they're saying is that our parents have helped us a lot. Okay, now our parents have helped us in growing up. Okay, they have helped us in developing good and bad habits. Okay, our parents, just as we were small, okay, we didn't know how to talk, we didn't know how to walk. Is that clear? Okay, we were so small, we didn't know what was right, what was wrong, how to talk, how to eat, how to walk. Okay, but our parents helped us. Okay, they helped us, how to walk, they helped us, how to talk, they told us what is right and what is wrong. Okay, just like our parents, the teachers are considered as our spiritual parents. What does the word spiritual parents mean? Spiritual means spirit. Okay, spirit kisi kehte hain ki they guide you, they groom you up. Okay, teachers don't teach you how to walk or how to how to eat, but they do teach you very good things. They educate you, they tell you what is right and what is wrong, and that is why the teachers are very important for us, and we are they are called as our spiritual parents. Up till now, do you have any conclusion? Any problem?
No.
Okay. No. Now, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us the knowledge of Islam and taught us the difference between what is right and wrong. Okay. Now, what they are saying is that in this comprehension is that teachers are very important. Why? Because our Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was also a teacher. Okay. A teacher is anyone who teaches us anything. Okay. If someone teaches us something, he automatically becomes our teacher. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us many good things. He told us about how to, accept Islam. He told people that how important Islam was, and he gave the teaching of Islam to every person. Okay, he was good to everyone, even if a person was Muslim or not Muslim. Prophet sallam used to be very good with him, and he used to always guide him. Okay. So that is why Prophet ﷺ is known as our teacher. That is clear?
Yes.
Okay. That is why there is a hadith of Muhammad ﷺ that certainly I have been sent as a teacher. He himself told everyone that I was sent as a teacher. Why? Because Allah Ta'ala sent Muhammad ﷺ to teach us. Okay. To teach the Muslims, to teach his tribe, like how to accept Islam. And after accepting Islam, he knew that we would be granted the Jannah. Okay, automatically every Muslim is going to go in the Jannah, and that is what he taught us. Okay, now whenever Prophet ﷺ told his companions anything, they would listen to him quietly and respectfully. They all respected and loved him so much that they would walk behind him and talk softly in front of him. Okay. Prophet had many companions. Okay, companions are basically his friends, his followers, people who grew up with him. Okay, just like our Caleb. You guys know who our Caleb are. We have already talked in the class. Okay, who are Calebs? Calebs are our Muslim leaders. Okay, just like Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq. Okay, Hazrat Ali. Okay, all the five Calebs are our. They are the Muslim leaders. They grew up with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them the teaching, and that is how they grew up a group. So, you know, no single person can help a group to develop. सिर्फ प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम अकेले होते तो आपको लगता है कि इस्लाम में इतनी जल्दी जल्दी तेजी से फैल सकता था, सही है? बट क्या हुआ कि क्योंकि प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के पास कैलिफ्स थे, ही हैड हिज कंपेनियंस, कंपेनियंस बेसिकली हिज फ्रेंड्स, हिज फॉलोअर्स. ओके, उन लोगों ने क्या किया, दे हेल्प प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम इन, यू नो, इन के इन स्प्रेडिंग इस्लाम. दैट इज क्लियर?
ओके,
ओके. नाउ Prophet ﷺ friends or his companions used to respect Muhammad ﷺ so much that whenever they used to talk to Muhammad ﷺ, they always speak in a very soft way, in a very polite way. They never used to shout at him, they never used to speak loudly with Prophet ﷺ. Okay? And whenever Prophet ﷺ was walking, they always used to walk behind him. Okay? Why? As to give him respect. Okay? At the old times, like for example, even now, when we're going somewhere, as you are small, you don't, maybe you don't do that. But if I'm going somewhere and if I saw an elder, okay, like for example, I have my grandmother or I have, you know, my nani or dadi, I let her walk first, okay, and I walk behind her. That is a way of giving respect, okay. So that is exactly what Prophet ﷺ companions used to do. They used to give him respect by walking behind. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes. Okay.
Now, I'm showing you some quotations of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that one who treads a path in search of knowledge has his path to paradise made easy by the God. What does this mean? It means Prophet ﷺ ne kya kaha hai ki if a person is searching for knowledge, if a person wants to be educated, okay, what will happen is that if a person is being educated, his path, his way to the heaven will become easier. Okay, yani kisse kya matlab hai, Prophet ﷺ ne kya kaha hai ki har insaan ko kya karna chahiye, he has to be educated, he has to have search for knowledge. And when he is searching for knowledge, he is going to be way to his heaven. Okay, so there is another quotation: a father gives his child nothing better than a good education. Okay, I think we have already studied this quotation in class as well, that the best thing our father gives us, the best thing that a father can give to his children is a good education. Okay,
knowledge.
Yes, knowledge basically. Okay, so any person, any student who is in search for knowledge, who likes to be educated, is obviously going in a better way to the heaven. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now moving forward, if you have questions, I'm going to ask you, so don't really panic. Okay. Okay. Now, the Prophet ﷺ cared for teachers and showed their ability to standing when he was passing by two circles of people. Okay, now this is a very good example of Prophet ﷺ. What happened is that once a time Prophet ﷺ was passing by two circles of people. What does it mean? There were two, for example, there were two rooms. Okay, in one room, the people were supplicating to God. What is the word supplicating means? So, yeah, it means praying to God.
Asking, worship.
Exactly. Asking or worshipping to God. So, yeah, and he commented, the first is begging to God why the God may or may not give them what they want. Okay. What happened is that there were two circles of people. Okay. One was supplicating to God, one was praying to God to give them what they want. Okay, in the other room, the other people were being taught new things by a teacher. Okay, so what happened is that two groups the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ne dono ko move karte hue dekha, to unko ek group join karna tha. Okay, automatically Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had to join one group. Okay, he had to join whether the people. Yes, he had to join whether the people that were worshipping, or he had to join the people that were being taught by a teacher. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that
he have joined the group of teaching.
Yes, exactly. He said that as I have been sent as a teacher. You know what he said to the people? He said that the people in the first group, that they were supplicating to God. Okay, he told the people that they are begging the God to listen to him. Okay, he told that maybe our prayers will not be listened. Okay, he said that maybe or maybe God will not listen to you this time. Okay, हर किसी प्रेयर का एक टाइम होता है ना, जब वो एक्सेप्ट होती है. ऐसा तो नहीं है कि अगर आज हम प्रे कर रहे हैं तो हमारी आज की प्रेयर जो है वो सुन ली जाएगी. ऐसा तो नहीं होता, सही है. तो प्रोफेसर साहब ने क्या कहा कि नॉट वेस्ट योर टाइम इन प्रेइंग राइट नाउ, इंस्टेड गो टू द सेकंड रूम एंड लर्न सम न्यू थिंग्स. ओके, एंड दैट इज व्हाई ही जॉइंड द सेकंड रूम. इज दैट क्लियर?
यस
यस.
ओके, इज इट इजी अप टिल नाउ?
यस.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank God. If you have any problem, you can ask me anytime. Okay. Now.
Okay.
What you're saying is that we should obey teachers regarding Holy Prophet ﷺ has said, respect the one from whom you gain knowledge. Okay. Why Islam has given teachers a very important status? Okay. Islam has given the teachers a very important status, just as important as our parents. Okay. Teachers are considered as the second parents of a student. Okay, so this why? Because we should respect. Yes, because we should respect everyone from which we gain knowledge from. Okay, and that is why Islam ke andar teachers ki kya hai, bahut zyada respect hai. Teachers are one of the highest status in Islam. Okay, once a companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Umar ibn Al Khattab radhiyallahu anhu said, the death of 1,000 worshippers is easier to bear than the death of a scholar who has the knowledge of what Allah has permitted and forbidden. Okay, so what does this mean is that Islam ke andar kya hota hai? Islam ke andar Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ne kya kaha? We are ready to sacrifice our warriors. We are ready to sacrifice our warriors. Agar kisi war ke andar, you know, our warriors are sacrificed. Okay, we lost many of our brave soldiers. He said that even if he lost 1,000 warriors, okay, he said that it will still be, not more if we lost a teacher. So, yeah, agar hum ek single teacher ko lose kar de na, to unhone kya kaha tha? Unhone kaha tha ki ye bahut zyada naam ke liye kya hoga, bahut zyada bura hoga. Why? Because educated teachers, the person who give knowledge, are given the most respect in Islam. So, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ne kya kaha ki agar ek taraf we lost over 1,000 warriors, और दूसरी तरफ अगर हमें भी 10 teachers को भी lose कर रहे हैं ना, तो the 10 teachers we are losing, ये क्या होगा? ये ज़्यादा Islam के लिए क्या है? ज़्यादा बुरा होगा. It is a very sad experience for Islam. Okay, up till now do you have any problem?
No.
No.
Okay. No. Okay. So what they said is that there are certain rules I have already taught you in class. Okay, when we were reading the chapter, but I'm revising you. I'm telling you that again, that there are certain points we should keep in our mind. Okay, what should we do when the teacher enters our class?
Greet her.
Greet her. Okay. Whenever I come into your class, you always stand up and say, good morning teacher, and assalamu alaikum. Okay, that is a way of showing respect. Okay, we should always listen to our teacher. We should always respect our teacher. Okay, if a person is disrespecting his teachers, so what happens is that he will be punished severely. Okay, beta, not speak please. Okay, पापा सासा ने क्या कहा है कि अगर कोई भी इंसान अपने टीचर को रिस्पेक्ट नहीं करेगा, इफ अ पर्सन इज नॉट रिस्पेक्टिंग हिज टीचर्स, तो क्या होगा कि उसको इसकी बहुत ज्यादा सीवियर पनिशमेंट मिलेगी. मतलब ही विल बी पनिश्ड वेरी बैड व्हेन ही विल गो इन द डे ऑफ जजमेंट. Okay, so we should always respect our teachers. And now I'm going to just give you a brief summary of the whole chapter that teachers are considered as ever. Which parents or teachers are considered as? Who's going to tell?
Second parents.
Okay, spiritual. And spiritual parents. Okay, basically second parents and spiritual parents. The word spiritual is more right. Okay, so Professor Salem was a dash himself. I'm asking you as a fill in the blanks. Professor Salem was sent as a dash himself. Teacher. Professor Salem was sent as a teacher himself. Okay. Okay. Why Professor Salem was said to be a teacher? Why do we call Professor Salem a teacher?
Because he was telling people how to about give Islam. Respects and about Islam.
Exactly. Why? Because he taught Muslims what is right and what is wrong, how important the religion of Islam is, and what will happen if you do follow this religion. Okay? Okay, so, okay. Which is more worse if we lose thousands of our warriors or 10 teachers? Which is more worse in Islam?
10 teachers. 10 teachers. I think
you all got my point. Okay. The companions of Prophet Sallam. The companions of Prophet Sallam.
Hello?
Yeah, kindly don't speak over here. Okay. Okay. The companions of The companions of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to give him respect. How?
I listen him.
I listen him.
I listen him
too quietly.
And yet they walk behind him.
Exactly. What? By giving him respect, they used to speak politely to him. They used to speak in a very polite way, and they used to always walk behind him. Okay, by giving him respect. Okay, so class, now we have studied our comprehension. Now what we are going to do is that I'm giving you a homework right now. Okay, the homework is basically is that you have to revise all the lecture that I've given you, and I'm going to ask you questions in the next class. Is that clear? There is no written homework. Okay, I will post a video in your homework. Just watch the video, revise your lecture, and that is your homework. Okay.
Okay, miss. Okay.
Do you have any problem?
No.
Okay. So this was it for today's lecture. Okay. I hope you all had fun. I hope you all understood what I was telling you. Okay.